Hi, my name is Rich. This is a 1935 convertible sedan I recently purchased, and I thought it would be worthwhile to make some videos of my restoration process as I go along. So follow along if you like, and watch this restoration process as it goes. Okay, in this video we're going to put the brake shoes back on. Show you what's involved with that. Before I do that, I'm just going to put some white lithium grease on these parts here so that they pivot okay. Let's make sure they still turn. I'll leave it like that so it gets the most clearance. Do the same on this side. Again, I'll leave it like that. Wipe off the excess. That way there's clearance for the brake shoes. Alright, first thing I want to do is just test fit these anchor pins. Put a little lube on here. Because I put some paint in there, make sure that one feels okay. We'll do the same with the other one. Okay. So the way I do this is take my brake shoe, put a little bit of this white lithium grease around the can. Put the can in the brake shoe. Feels good. More lithium around here in these pivot points, just a little bit, and I'll do this. Okay, so that's fit in the cam. These really rusted up when I took this off, so maybe this will help. Put this one in first. Let's put the bolt on the back finger tight. Do the same for the other side. I'm just going to loosen this up a tad. Alright, put the vice grips on the back. Let me push the brake shoe up. Let's make sure the little notch is in the right spot. The brake shoe goes into this little clip here. check. You can see how the cam is moving the bottom of the brake shoe in and out. So that side looks good. Let's do the same on the other side. Okay, next I want to put in these little pins before I put the brakes in place. So we'll give them a little bit of lube. The short pin goes up in the front. A longer pin in the back. Longer pin in the back. Something like that. And this one goes up like that. Like what I'm going to do is put the pin in that. The spring in next. Okay, we got a new brake spring. And it's always kind of tricky. Let's see. Okay, lesson learned. I had a terrible time getting the parking brake on, and it's because the spring was lined up this way, and it was hitting here, so we're going to take this off and rotate it around that way, so the spring is back lower. So, once again, put this up here, and install the spring. Alright? Let's try and get this spring on here this time. You want to wear goggles when you're doing this. Okay, here's the tip I learned is the spring. Make sure the spring is on the inside there. See how this one's on the outside and this part's on the inside. So that way it won't interfere when we put in the parking brake piece, which is something I was struggling with earlier. So we're going to go ahead and put the parking brake piece back on now. Put a little bit more lube on here. Let's try and put this piece on first. That went on so much easier. And this piece here. Okay, now that we got the emergency brake portions on, I have these like horseshoe clamps, but I prefer to use these E-clips instead. I'm going to put that on. I got a vice grip on the back of the nut here, and I'm just checking the movement of the brake with the cam. Everything's not tightened down yet, but that's what it will look. That's the way it works. And now I'm just on the other side, making sure I have movement in there. Looks good. This will be important when I go to adjust the brakes. Okay, my last step here is to put the emergency brake cable in. Goes to the back. Comes out this way. And I'll put this clip in. Let's check the emergency brake. Looks good. You know what I think I might do is just put a little bit of lithium grease on this. Just a dab. Go. Looks good.